Welcome. We come on this day to celebrate the life of Jan Myers. We give God thanks for the many lives that she touched. And we today gathered in homes throughout the country that we can come together and celebrate this great life. Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Jan, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death. So that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. And Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. At this time, we're going to sing our opening hymn, number 742, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Jan. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. One of the readings that Jan had sent me that she would ask me to read on this day, the celebration of her life, was Psalm 74, verse 26. And when I looked that up, I found out that there is no 26 verses in Psalm 74. So Jan, when we meet above, you're going to have to tell me what you intended. But you also had Psalm 121. So let me begin. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in, from this time on and forevermore. And from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to Jesus, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And if you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. At this time, we'll sing In the Garden. Thank you. At this time, I would like to read the eulogy that was put together by Jan's daughter, Jill, and it is titled Mother's Quilt. Every great quilt starts with a pattern, a plan as to what fabric, what design, and what size of quilt you want to make. You cut the fabric, align it to make a pattern, you sew it with thread, bind the edges, and quilt a pattern in between. My mom's life was like a quilt, vibrant fabric of life's designs, strong thread of family and friends that held it together in good times and in bad. My mother's quilt began one night when Susan Pankratz and Harold Olson both met on a dance floor in Mountain Lake, Minnesota. They soon were married and started a family, and the blocks from this portion of the quilt were full of family, joy, struggle, and resilience. My Uncle Kenny was the first child born. Soon my mom, Janice Helen Olson, was brought into this world November 1st, 1938. A few years later, her brother Keith was born. He was only with us for a few short months, but was an important block of my mom's quilt. Later, my Aunt Joyce rounded out the family. All of them bonded together with the thread and fabric of family and love. Her childhood held many different fabrics, family farming in Mountain Lake, a move to Mayhew Lake, cousins and extended family are always a big part of her life. Family traditions handed down from generation to generation, including Lefse, lutefisk, quilting, family trips to northern Minnesota to fish and make lasting memories. Church was always the foundation of their family. My grandpa would make them get up early every Sunday morning so that they could be the first one in the parking lot. My mom always treasured the church hymns and found peace in them. School years were filled with lifelong friendships that are still strong today. Even though it may look like a crazy quilt, and I'm sure at many times it felt like she didn't know where life was taking her, the pattern of my mother's quilt was well planned out by God. It is like the saying, if you ever want to hear God laugh, tell him your plans. Because no matter how hard you try to plan, God's plan is much greater than you can ever create on your own. One beautiful April spring day, my mom and a friend went for an ordinary horseback ride, not realizing a new set of blocks was about to be added to her quilt. They were riding the countryside of rural Minnesota when a car pulled up because one of the passengers recognized the two girls. As fate would have it, a handsome young man, fresh out of the Air Force, was riding in the car and was introduced to his friend, to my mom, and was instantly taken by her true beauty. 5 months later, Dwayne Myers and Janice Olson were married on October 10th, 1956. A Wednesday night at a church in Mountain Lake, Minnesota. Love, white lace, and pearls were added to my mother's quilt. 1 year later, my mom and dad started another roll of their quilt. Fabric of rattles and diapers were added when my brother Kevin was born. The next year, they were blessed with a daughter, Jolene. Julie rounded out the family of five a few years later. They waited a while, sewed these pieces together, stretched the life around family and friends. They hosted dance lessons in their Cedar Grove basement that didn't result in any dance competition winners. They took family vacations camping in Canada and traveling around the states. As many of my cousins have told me, our house in Young America was the center of family events. My parents were their second parents, the matriarchs of the family, bonding the extended families together. And before long, they decided to add a couple more kids to this crazy quilt. And my sister Jennifer and I were brought into the Meyer clan, followed by 13 grandchildren, 13 great-grandchildren, cousins, nieces, nephews, too many friends to count. The quilt of fabric along the way from their many moves included Mountain Lake, Springfield, Rochester, Minneapolis, Cedar Grove, Shakopee, Northwood, Young America, Cologne, Waconia, Green Isles, Sacred Heart, Iowa, Eden Prairie, Webb Lake, Waite Park, and Spooner. And I'm sure I might have missed a couple. They were never afraid to try a new experience and see what life had to offer. My mom is one of the hardest working people I have known. She instilled in all of us a work ethic we can't break free from. Her work and volunteer positions included, but are not limited to, business owner, factory worker, server, crafter, secretary, cleaner, resort manager, lady circle, choir parent, lioness, and endless church volunteer positions. In her spare time, when she wasn't at every sporting event, play, choir concert, special event, for not only her children, but for her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Baking treats no one could stop eating, making the world's best potato salad. Yes, we got the recipe, but not sure the magic touch. Crafting, finding the next new craft project, very possibly never finishing, but buying it with good intentions of finishing. Having the grandchildren and great-grandchildren make multicolored animal-shaped pancakes. She cherished her book club and was an avid reader, and a go-to when you were looking for the next read. Teaching us lefse rolling techniques we can pass on. Joining the Sons of Norway with Julie and learning more about the heritage. Finishing our 4-H projects, volunteering for the Lions iBank in Minneapolis and Mexico. Being a world traveler, including most of the 50 states, England, Germany, Austria, Mexico, Guam, Japan, Italy, and traveling anywhere to visit friends and family around country and world. She idolized Amelia Earhart and would have flown if she had the chance. Multiple trips to visit me in Florida over the past 10 years, walking the beach, relaxing, enjoying a vodka tonic, and eating too much food. Playing tenpenny and teaching the next generation how Grandma Susan taught us. Driving on whoopty roads in Webster, Wisconsin, like she was a race car driver. My kids might disagree. This was a good thing since they get car sick easily. And of course, quilting. The list goes on, and each block of this quilt is more colorful and different than the pattern next to it. She was an amazing wife, mother, nana, sister, aunt, cousin, friend, and co-worker. She was the person I had on speed dial when I needed someone to cry to tell about the most exciting news, or just to share a simple joy of the day. We got the news 11 months ago that she had maybe 2 months to finish the quilt, which was started on a dance floor so many years ago. And we rushed to finish the binding, add a few blocks and insulation to keep her warm and wrap her in love. But again, as you know, life doesn't always go as planned. We had more time than we could have ever asked for and are so blessed by the memories that we got to make. She never complained. She always worried more about us than herself. And the quilt has become frayed and was tested to the limits, but it survived, as all good quality quilts should. The good news is she left us extra fabric and thread to mend it and to add on to our own beautiful, crazy quilts. God had been watching, saw her work, and knew it was time for her to catch the flight for the next adventure. She'd been on standby for the last 11 months, and finally they had an open seat. I was sure he gave her a blue ribbon for her quilt, because as the saying goes, whoever dies with the most fabric wins. Congratulations, Mom, you did it. She told me a few days ago her bags were packed and she was ready. She got her wish on June 28, 2020, surrounded by family and friends from near and far, either in her presence or in their thoughts. Each of us untying to wrap her, uniting to wrap her in quilts of love. My dad had the plane waiting, her first class ticket ready for her. Her quilt goes on in each of us. She had lived a life well lived. Thank you for being part of this amazing journey. Let us now sing hymn number 732, Morning Cry.
I'm Grace to you and peace from God the Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let me begin today by giving thanks for Jan's amazing family. Jan shared so much with you over the course of her life. And in the last chapter of her life on this earth, you were there for her every step of the way. I give thanks to Kevin and Dee Dee for opening up your home and welcoming in your mother to stay. I give thanks for the daughters, Jody and Julie, Jennifer, Jill, and the grandchildren for being there to care for your mom, grandma. It's been a blessing for me to get to know you better. And I see so much of Jan and Dwayne shining through you. And so their legacy carries on. Jan had an amazing faith in God. And I believe it was that faith that centered her life. And it's a tradition here at Lakeside that when we have a baptism, that one of the things that we do, we have the tradition where we hand usually the sponsor a candle, because usually it's infants that are baptized. And as we pass that candle, we say these words, is that let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and give God thanks in heaven. Well, Jan, you certainly let your light shine in so many ways. By all of the things, you touch so many lives, and you always, in just your genuine nature, your caring nature, and your loving nature, you certainly were a bright light. From my early days at Lakeside, I had appreciation for Jan because she liked my farm stories, having spent some time growing up on a farm herself. And there's something true to the saying that, you can take the kid off the farm, but you really can never take the farm out of the kid. And she also even smiled at my fishing stories. And then she would from time to time tell me some fishing stories of her own. And one of the last meals that Jan was able to eat while she was upon this earth is that her son Kevin put together a fish fry. And Jan loved walleye, but Kevin hadn't caught any walleye. But he said he had one jumbo perch. He said it was huge, and so he said, Mom, he said, it's the next best thing to a walleye what's on your plate. And she was so excited that she barely finished the prayer before there was perch on her fork and heading to her mouth. She was blessed, and she was fortunate that she was able to keep her appetite right to the very end and enjoy meals with the family. And not only was she able to keep her appetite, but she also was able, her mind was as sharp as ever, and she kept her humor. For just the last few days, Jan was actually bedridden. And so the bedroom was sort of not far off of the kitchen. And one morning, Kevin was grinding coffee beans for the morning brew. And between the sound of the grinder and the aroma that went through the house, he heard these words coming from the bedroom. I suppose I'm not going to get any of that. Her sense of humor. And even when she found out I was talking to one of her quilting friends. And when Jan found out that, she only had a couple more months, that ended up being 11. But the cancer was back. And so she told her quilting friend, she said, well, I guess Dwayne's getting impatient. Those last 11 months were precious. And I'm so glad that Jan was able to come back to the area. And I treasure the visits that my wife, Ron, and I were able to have with Jan. There was something about her personality, her nature. You'd come in and you'd ask Jan how she was doing, and she would say, oh, I'm fine. And then want to find out, how are you doing? What's going on in your life? How are your kids doing? And that was just part of her personality. That it was never so much about her, but it was always about others. Letting her light shine. Every visit we would finish, we would have communion. And then Jan would get up out of her chair and she would walk to the bedroom and she would come out with her offering, an envelope. And she would hand it to me and say, "Now make sure that gets into the..." And then all of a sudden, the first of the year came and she started bringing out her offering in just a plain envelope because she didn't have her offering envelopes, because they were sitting in my garage. I knew exactly where they were, but she was so ready to go home, and I just couldn't bring it to myself to give her another year's worth of offering envelopes. And so she would remind me every now and then, "Do we have the envelopes?" And I would forget every time. Sorry, Jan, on purpose. I was talking with a couple from Lakeside, and they were sharing in the days when one of the events they would, you know, these Scandinavians and their desire for lutefisk and lefse. And so they were said they would get together, and Dwayne and Jan would come over, and Bob and Marilyn Olson, and Eiler and Lolita Anderson, and the whole room, you know, would be filled with the smell of lefse and lutefisk. Although, quite honestly, I don't know how you can smell anything if there's lutefisk in the air. Sort of dominating. But I thought about that as one of the most challenging parts about being here as a pastor at Lakeside, is that there comes a time when, often when people have to say goodbye. And for Eiler and Lolene Anderson, they moved away from the area, and same with Bob and Marilyn Olson. And we had to say our goodbyes, and then, you know, a few years back, as Dwayne went to his eternal home. And then the time came where finally she had been so patient and waiting. You know, one of the daughters had called me and said, "You know, Pastor Bill, I think things are changing. And if you could give Mom a call, that would be great." It was right in the midst of the COVID when nobody knew what to do, and well, we still don't, but we weren't making any visits. And so almost immediately I called Jan and I said to her, "So I hear that things are changing." And her response was this: "I sure hope so." She was so ready to go home. And so when the day finally came, and that Dwayne was waiting for her in her home in heaven. Boy, what a smile, I'm sure it was upon Jesus' face when he got to welcome Jan home. And then I remembered that as difficult as it is as saying goodbye, it's not really goodbye, is it? It's really not. In fact, I think of the old song that I'm going to close with today. It's not goodbye, but it's until we meet again. And so it goes like this: Till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet. God be with you till we meet again. Jan, may God be with you. And I look forward to the day when we can meet again. Amen.
At this time, let us listen to the song, "I Can Only Imagine."
What my eyes will see when your face I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. When that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun, I can only imagine when all I will do is forever, forever worship you. I can only
let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, that they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to all of us who still walk in our pilgrimage by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and your life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Help us in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and to trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of life everlasting. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Together let us pray our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, let us sing our hymn, Beautiful Savior, hymn number 838. Let us continue with the commendation. Let us commend Jan to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Janice Helen Olson Myers. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints of light. Amen. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend our sister Jan, and we commit her ashes to the deep. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. May the Lord bless her, and may the Lord keep her. May the Lord's face shine upon her and be gracious to her. May the Lord look upon with her favor and grant her peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this time, let us sing our sending song today, I'll Fly Away.